Hello, party people, and welcome to Duhok Men's Basketball. Joined here at Lillis Court, I'm with my man, Matt Haddad. Matt, how you doing?
I'm doing great, man. Just came off that women's game, ready for this men's game. It's going to be a great night.
Yeah, and for all you viewers listening that tuned into football, I bet you didn't think you could get rid of me that easily now, could you? So, Matt, who you got your eyes on for today's game?
Ali Sabet, man. He's got 21 points last game, 29 minutes, 7 from 12 from the field goal. Three-pointers, he was 5 of 6. I mean, the guy is just electric. I'm expecting a lot out of him from this game.
And, I mean, our men, only one game in, Rockford 2-0. You got anybody looking forward to win this game outright?
Duhawks, baby. I mean, come on. Got to go with my school. Duhawks, I think they're just going to come out electric, firing. They're going to keep clicking, hitting all cylinders. I mean, I'm expecting a lot from them.
Yeah, and after the starting lineups, we'll pick back up with you guys. Starting lineups here for today's game. Looks like it's going to be a good one.
I'm so pumped for this game, man. Duhawks back at home. Saturday night basketball. College football's finishing up too. Great win for a couple of those teams. But hey, my focus is on this Duhawks basketball team tonight.
Yeah, and last year in the COVID year, our men did play Rockford, and they almost blew a pretty big lead last year. They're up by around 15-20 points at the end of the first half. Comes down the second half, gets down to a 3-4 point game, and Duhawks end up pulling that one out by around like 7-ish, 5-ish points.
I think one thing you can take from that game is be relentless. Don't let up. Just because you're up big doesn't mean, you know, you are gonna, you know, play a little bit easier, a little bit lighter on defense. Put your foot on the gas and go hard to the fourth quarter, hit zero.
Yes, sir. The starters for your Loras College Duhawks, number 3, Ali Sabet. Number 20, Miles Berry. Number 21, Rowan McGowan. Number 22, Jackson Kalinski. And number 23, Cole Navigado. We got 3 seniors and then 2 sophomores in there. As the Duhawks just win that tip. Rockford even jumped for that one. Berry bringing it up, dumps it off. Duhawks 3-point line now. Little screen pass, giving it up. Navigado with it, driving in, kicks out to Berry. Berry gets it to Sabet. Ali running it, gets that screen from his big man Kalinski. Ali dumping it off and it turns it over.
You want to be strong and you want to be quick, but you got to have good vision too.
Rockford coming out with a thunderous dunk to start this game.
He came out firing, baby.
Setting the tone for the game.
Like I said before the game, I wanted to see somebody dunk and I got it pretty early.
Yeah, I mean, wow, that was thunderous. Duhawks maybe a little shaken after that. I mean, that got my blood pumping early.
It was an electrifying play.
Duhawks for 3. Count it! Duhawks answer right back with a 3 from Rowan McGowan, who leads his Duhawks in scoring. Last game, like we said earlier, it's only their second game. He scored around 25 points last game, leading the Duhawks in scoring. The transfer, Ali Sabet, was second that game as Rockford going up for it again. No good. Berry pushing up the court now.
Miles Berry out of Naperville North. He was a big, huge key last year as a freshman, playing an even bigger role this year as a sophomore.
Kalinski, the big man, using that big frame he's got and putting that one through the hoop for 2. Rockford dumping it off to number 2, Micah Swanson. Swanson driving in. His layup no good. Good defense there by Kalinske. Barry pushing up the court now. Barry using that quick speed. Dumps it off to McGowan. McGowan driving in. Step back. Gives up to Navigado. Back to McGowan. McGowan three, no good. Rebound, Rockford.
That Loras bench, they were looking to go crazy. Ooh, just off the hands of Barry. Looks like
Ali bringing it up on the wing. Ali pulling up for three. The lefty drains it. Duhawks lighting it up early here, just like the woman in the last game.
Exactly. I mean, Rockford got that huge dunk. The Loras, they're up six, man. And that's a travel, too, benefiting the Duhawks any way they can.
Wow, this Duhawk team has really come to play now as we get a couple subs in the game. Number one, Tyler Bass, the freshman guard out of Washington, Illinois, checks into the game, as well as number 15, Griffin Clark, the senior from Fairfax, Iowa, a transfer from Kirkwood Community College. Ali running the point now, gets to Kalinske. Bass has it now in the post, looking to go up with it. The guard with his long arms gets it blocked. Rockford running up the court now, brought up by DJ Bonds. Number 11, Nick Phelps with the ball, a senior. Swanson with a nice little spin move on the post. Dumps it off. Rockford loses it. Phelps for three? No good, but there is a foul, and I believe they're going to call this one as he's shooting. That's something you can't have there, Matt. You can't be following a three-point shooter.
I mean, three-point shooting, that's going to possibly lead to a four-point play. That'll catch up to you. You got to stop fouling behind the arc. I mean, if you get in that fouling range, it's just going to hurt you in the long run.
Out there for Rockford right now, number zero, Jaden Bell. Number one, Brandon Emmerich. Number two, Micah Swanson. Number three, TJ Lacey. Number 11, Nick Phillips. Phillips, a senior. He's at the line right now for her. He's got two more shots. He's got fouled on three. And last year, the game that we came through for highlights, he really kind of carried this Rockford Regents team. And that senior leadership is really going to help out Rockford this year.
I wouldn't be surprised. I was going to say, if he just, you know, kind of puts his team on their back, I mean, and just carries them to a W, and, you know, it's going to be a team effort from Loras. They just can't have a one-man show.
Duhawks really spread it out here for Ali. Gets some McGovern. McGovern gets in the paint, puts it up with a little baby hook. Rowan McGowan. Ali picking up the ball carrier.
Rowan McGowan, he's actually a graduate student. He's been here quite a while. He's packing up the stats.
McGowan, really the leader of this Duhawk offense, wouldn't you say so?
I would definitely agree with you, Hugh.
Rockford going up, and he gets a tough finish.
That's
number
the kind
10,
of plays.
DJ Bonds.
Duhawks are going to have to stop those kinds of plays. Work in the court, work in the baseline. That'll get you.
Duhawks really working it around. McGowan trying to body Swanson. Fadeaway, no good. Rockford loses it. Kalinske with the foul. Oh, almost gets the and one.
Two Regents players from Rockford were going after it. You know, miscommunication there. Could have had a rebound, but I didn't think they realized they were on each other's teams.
Jackson Kalinske looks like he's the tallest guy on the court right now, but number two for Rockford, Micah Swanson, right behind him at 6'5". Kalinske's first free throw is good, and speaking of Micah Swanson, 6'5", 225 as a freshman. I mean, almost he could be playing football with that size. So we get some subs into the game here for the Duhawks. Number 25, Declan Serlich, the sophomore out of McCowan, Wisconsin, checks into the game. Kalinske hits both as the freshman. Number 32, Alex checks into the game.
Loras is 90% from free throws, 18 and 20. Now they're 20 and 22. Doing great there.
Alex Singleton checks into the game for the Duhawks. And it looks like Miles Berry checked back in for Ali Sabet. And Cole Navigado's also back into the game. Swanson has at the free throw line. Swanson trying to body Navigado. Navigado, good defense there, forcing Swanson to miss that one. Outlets it to Barry. Barry gives it to the freshman, Alex Singleton. Alex driving in. Looks like they're going to call a travel there. And talking to Our big man, David Grinches, in class, he said Alex Singleton, he's got a bright future here for the Duhawks.
I wouldn't be surprised. I mean, he looks like the kind of guy that can carry this team. I mean, he's coming in.
He's not listed on the sheet.
Darn.
He's coming in tall.
He is a tall guy.
As the Rockford Regents nail a three. Brandon Emmerich bring it to a three-point game now. Barry with the ball. Gets it to Alex Singleton. Alex. As the Duhawks hit a three, the Duhawks just lighting it up from downtown.
I mean, like the women's game, I mean, Madison Haslow, she was lighting it up. Loras men's team is trying to do the same.
As there's a travel there on Rockford, and they are not happy. It's looking like it's going to be a good game so far, Matt.
DJ Bond is trying to maybe negotiate with the ref a little bit, but no budge there.
Clark's got it now. He's pressured by Phillips. Phillips seals it away. Nice little move. And he airballs the layup. Is that travel?
Airballs it to himself? I'm not too sure.
Ref saying it's not travel. Head coach Chris Martin is not happy about that one. Clark here. There's a stop on the play. Looks like they're going to call a foul on number 11, Nick Phillips, with a push.
And then, you know, Duhawks, they got to capitalize on that stuff. Any small little mistake like that, they got to really make the most out of those. You know, get to the free throw line, shoot the threes, get in the paint. Anything you can do, like right here. Ooh,
Declan just got it swatted back, but right back to Cole Navigato, who uses quick reflexes to put that one up.
Cole Navigato's, he's a senior this year out of Geneva. Actually, my hometown, actually.
Oh. Did you know him back in the day?
I did not, but he was, let me tell you, he was a star at Geneva High School. The man was putting up monster points.
Charles Brunell checked in here for Rockford, the last dead balls. Bonds goes up with it over Declan. Declan just too tall and strong for Bonds. He's bringing up the court now. Declan gets up for three. Ooh. No good. Clark with the miss, and they're going to call a foul on Navigato. So Duhawk's second team foul of the half. Rockford also two team fouls. 17-11 here with just under 7 minutes played in this game. Brunell bringing it up the court. Picked up by number 13, Drew Wallenschlager. Barry now playing good defense. Good defense right here from the Duhawks. As I say, there's a back cut. Rockford going up with it. TJ Lacey with the good finish.
And TJ Lacey had an open shot. Navigato had his back to him, but found the open guy, and Navigato tried to contest the shot.
This Rockford bench really lively out there.
I mean, they're calling the plays themselves.
Oh, Navigato with the spin move, loose, and they're going to call a foul.
He went up. It didn't go up with the ball, but he's going to head to the free throw line.
That foul's on number three, TJ Lacey, the 6'2", 200-pound senior guard out of Chicago.
It'll be interesting to see this game because Rockford being in Illinois, close to Chicago, I know Loras tries to pull from a lot of guys from that area, so maybe a little connection here or there or something.
As Navigato misses the first one from the charity strike. And the freshman, Micah Swanson, checks back in for Rockford. Navigato, second free throw is good. In the Duhawks last game, they were pretty good from the free throw line. And they went 18 of 20 last game for 90% as Rockford misses a three-pointer. Getting up to Alex. Alex gets fouled. Ooh. Felt kind of awkwardly there.
Yeah.
Got to hope he's okay after that one.
I mean, he is a freshman, but you just got to hope with his type of size, him, Navigato, Jackson, those are the kind of guys that you got to feed the ball to down in the paint. They'll put up great numbers for you if you use them.
Alex Singleton looking to get his first points of the game right here. Alex, free throw. Ooh, that's a nice stroke right there.
He doesn't seem like the kind of guy that'll miss.
No. Neither does Duhawk team, really. I mean, 90% last game, 18 for 20. I mean, I'm sure Coach Martin, he's got to be happy with that. I mean, if you're really nitpicky, you'd be like, why can't we go 100? But, hey.
Yeah.
Alex's second free throw's up. Oh, and it's short. Giving the Duhawks a 6-point lead. Rockford pushing it up. Ooh, nice bounce pass. Nice finisher by Micah Swanson.
I mean, the speed by Swanson and the vision by Brandon Emmerich. I mean, those two connect, and it's electrifying.
Alex Singleton with it. Gets it to the transfer sophomore, Ali Sabet. Ali out of Chicago, Illinois. Ali, a little between the legs, a little ISO real quick. Can't go anywhere with it. Gets it up to Drew. Drew gets to McGowan. McGowan's double teamed.
They got 2 seconds. Put it up. Throw it up.
Oh, from the logo. Oh, whoa! And he hits it.
Let's go.
From the logo.
Let's go. Oh, my goodness.
You've heard of Logo Dame. Now welcome to Logo Rowan. Rowan. Rockford trying to answer right back. No good. Alex running in there for that rebound. Pushing it up.
Loras, they got 26 rebounds this season, but Alex.
Oh, a big boy finisher by Alex Singleton as Rockford needs a timeout.
He takes that one coast to coast, gets the rebound, and gets the points.
That was a nice finish there by Alex protecting that ball, and he was a state champion in high school as well.
Wow.
So, I mean, bringing that championship mentality over to the collegiate level just as a freshman.
I mean, you said he's a freshman. He's going to be an impactful player here this season and so on and so forth. And Chris Martin, the coach of the Duhawks, really scored big getting him in the offseason.
Looking at Rockford over the season, they're two games in. They're 56 for 144. That's 39% from the for field goal. That's not too bad. Looking at it, and then three-point line, they're shooting 29%. Any improvement you can see there, Matt?
Reps, man. Get them running suicide, so when they're throwing the free throws, I mean, their knees are bending. I mean, it's just repetition. I mean, I wasn't the best free throw shooter, but one thing I learned is anything in life, it's just the reps.
Yeah, and then from the free throw line, they're shooting 80, and their assists to turnovers, not too good. 30 assists to 31 turnovers. That's, you want to definitely switch that up.
Get those assists higher, lower those turnovers. I mean, 15 and a half turnovers per game. I mean, they got 21 steals, which is good in the two games. But, I mean, that turnover, I mean, you just got to decrease that number.
Yeah.
That's killing you.
But this Rockford team definitely has some potential. 2-0 start the season.
Yeah.
Looking to extend that to 3-0, but these Duhawks definitely going to have something to say about that. Oh, Rockford for three. Drains it from the corner. Number five, Zach Centers, the sophomore out of Hugo, Minnesota.
Centers, he came to play, man. He's starting off hot. We'll see if he'll be able to continue.
Bass with it now to McGowan. McGowan wide open for three on the wing. Misses. Duhawks can't get the rebound. Rockford running transition. Emmerich dumps off to Swanson with another beautiful pass. Swanson can't finish there. Good job by Kalinske to break up that easy layup.
Brandon Emmerich, he was running to the other side in disbelief that ball didn't go in. Having a word with the coach.
Brandon Emmerich's actually the leading scorer for this Rockford team, averaging 16 a game. So, I mean, he's really doing it all out there for Rockford, being the leading scorer and moving the ball around.
Someone's got to do it. I mean, they got such great players on this team. If it's not him, then who else is it?
Yeah. Swanson hits the first out of two from the free throw line. Swanson going through his routine, puts it up, and drills it. Swanson looking good from the free throw line. Looks like he's 4 for 4. Ali driving in. Ali, nice move by Ali. Gets it McGowan for three. McGowan, that one's short. Kalinske using that big frame for the putback layup.
You talk about following your shot, follow your guy. I mean, he threw it up there, couldn't quite get it in. Kalinske. He's a big man using his height. I mean, I know he's covering Micah Swanson, who's coming in at 6'5". That's not slowing down Jackson Kalinske. He's putting up a fight.
Yeah. Foul there on Drew Wallenschlager, the sophomore. Charles Burnell throwing it in for Rockford, the senior, playing for his hometown college. Getting up to Emmerich. Emmerich. Doesn't use the screen from Swanson. Swanson, I don't know if he'll be shooting many threes from out there. Rockford looking for, they got a mismatch. Swanson on Ali. Ali, good box out. Good rebound there by Kolinsky.
Rockford, you got to get Swanson down in the paint. He's going to be a huge factor for you if you can.
Ali's three. Oh, he knew that one was in.
There we go,
put
baby.
Put the hands down right after he shot it. Got to be no better feeling than that.
McGowan was running across the baseline, saw Sabet. Bang, hit the three.
That was good vision there by Rowan, too. As the Duhawks force a turnover, and man, I just can't help but notice how long Tyler Bass's arms are. I mean, he's listed at 6'6", 175, and his arms are even longer than that. Which will really help out the Duhawks on defense, having a freshman with that kind of length, and over time, he'll obviously grow into it.
I mean, between Singleton, Sabat, Bass, this Duhawks team, they got a bright future.
Good patience there by Rowan. Not going up right away.
They got a graduate student who's setting a great example, too.
Yeah. TJ Lacey with it. Looking to dump it off Swanson. Swanson on Kolinsky. Kolinsky, good defense, but Swanson says the best kind of defense is good offense.
One thing Tyler Bass could have done was just swat his hand in there, tried to break up that ball between Swanson, but hey, he's a freshman, got a long road ahead.
Yeah. Ashton Singleton checked in now for Rockford as Rowan just goes in. Nobody contesting him there. Rockford looking to push it. High scoring game so far, 33-22 with 9:30 left in the first half. Swanson with it now. Been in matchup all day, and they're going to call a foul on Drew. It looks like Drew's kind of unnecessary reach there.
Yeah, they got a whole new rotation coming in for the Duhawks. Miles, Singleton, Navigado, Declan. Giving these guys a break, a much earned one too.
Yeah, they've done well. Kind of surprised we haven't seen our big man Dave Grinch is in yet. The 7-foot senior out of West Bend, Wisconsin, the transfer from UW Whitewater. He was here last year, and man, he is all of 7 foot.
I would love to see him play. Get a stuff maybe. Mm-hmm. I mean, we saw that electrifying dunk.
Yeah.
Maybe if he was down there, he could have blocked that one, but man.
Or maybe you could have got put on a post or one of the two.
Hopefully
either way,
it
would have been a highlight.
Yeah. Would have definitely made it. Maybe on SportsCenter if anybody was out here recording, but.
Oh, they would have saw our video.
We would have been on SportsCenter, yeah.
20 seconds here after the refs clear up what the shot clock should have been, and Miles knocking that one away. Scrap for the ball on the ground.
Oh,
Navigado,
great job by Navigado.
Barry pushing up the court as Rockford tried to take a three, moving it around. Declan on the wing. Duhawks slowing it down here. Looking, give it to Cole. He's got a mismatch. Cole's got the much smaller Charles Burnell on him. He's only listed at 5'10", 175. Navigado, 6'5", 205. Got to give it to him. Declan for three. Rims in and out, but Navigado putting that work in.
Oh, he got all ball.
And Singleton with the putback.
Navigado was looking for a foul, but I couldn't hear anything from up. I mean, I'm up here, but.
Yeah. Singleton looking to get to Swanson. Swanson's been their main source of offense so far in this game.
Yeah.
He's got 6 points, leading the team in scoring right now. Just a nice baby hook, and they're going to call. And looks like an off-ball foul. A Miles Berry? It looks like they're going to count it?
What?
I don't know if he called it before or after the bucket.
Who's ever covering Swanson, whether it's Cole Navigado or Jackson Kolinsky, those guys are going to have their hands full this evening for sure.
Definitely. Roma Gowan, the leading scorer here for the Duhawks, with 12 points already in this first half, and we're just over halfway through it.
I'm expecting this one to be a high-scoring game.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, we're almost halfway to 50.
I love me some high-scoring basketball games.
Yeah.
Good defense by the Duhawks as Singleton's getting picked up by Clark. Duhawks switching this thing. Clark, good defense. Declan knocking that one away. He's got one man to beat. Oh!
Ooh.
Interesting foul there by Nick Phillips. Phillips didn't really make a play on the ball, in my opinion, but Declan did bring that one down. Looks like he's a little shaken up after running into the banister there.
Yeah, hopefully he's okay. He's another key player for this Duhawk team. Sophomore too, so he was on this team last year during that COVID year. You know, I think this year he's really being able to connect with his teammates and his coaches with a lot of restrictions last year.
Declan's first free throw is up and is good. this Duhok offense really came to play, kind of shooting the lights out.
Yeah, I mean, electrifying dunk to start out the game from Rockford, but I mean,
both teams are shooting at a high clip. 61% for the Duhawks, 56 for Rockford. As Declan missed that, but Navigado's there again.
Special three-point play, and it goes.
Wow, Navigado, just he's everywhere on the boards right now. As Phillips kicks out of the corner for a three. Three-pointer, no good. I believe that was an air ball.
Who else than Navigado to come up with that one?
Barry dumps off to Navigado. Navigado driving in. Misses the layup. Declan crashing in. Kicks out to Barry. Barry.
Oh, Barry wanted to go.
Slows it down and turns it over. It's a little too high there for Alex Singleton.
I mean, you see the way Navigado's playing now. He was playing that same way at Geneva. He was all over the court. He's actually got three brothers, too. One of them played at Toledo College in the MAC conference. But, I mean, he just comes from a long line of good basketball players.
TJ Lacey checked back in for Rockford, as well as DJ Bonds. Lacey driving in. Oh, good move there by Lacey. Thought he might travel, but pretty sure the ref's saying he tipped that one. Barry looking to push it up, and, you know, he's got to be smarter than that. Those full court passes are always a little risky, Matt.
Yeah, I mean, you know, you want to get the ball down there, get scoring as fast as you can. You don't really want to set up a play, but that might be the smart thing to do in situations like that. Choose some time off the clock, get a play set up, and get some points on the board. Don't try to make as many mistakes as that.
Miles Berry setting up the offense here. Gets it to Clark. Clark dumped off Navigado. Declan wide open. Gets the finish. DJ Bonds went flying after that one. It's a nice spin move by Declan.
Maybe DJ Bonds just slipped up or something. I'm not too sure, but Declan capitalizes.
Rockford getting a little loose with the ball. As Bonds goes in, Alex trying to take a charge. No call. Good defense by the Duhawks. Good rotation by Miles Berry. And I know a lot of coaches, they preach defense. And, Matt, just how big is defense to win games?
Defense is huge. I mean, you know what the saying goes, defense wins championships.
Yes, sir.
That may be used for football, but that's even more prevalent here in basketball.
As the score is 40-26, and we're not even out of the first half yet. Rockford for three, no good. Alex can't handle it, and the ref's going to say off of Loras. Looks like it hit off a knee.
Singleton shaking his head, saying it wasn't off me.
There's always going to be some talking with the refs, especially in basketball.
Yeah.
Bonds dumps it off, beats Alex off the inbound.
Man.
He caught Alex in the air trying to kick that pass, not to get it in. He just beat him off the ball. Nice entry pass by Alex, and they're going to call a foul on Rockford.
Okay.
Foul on number zero, Jaden Bell.
First time we've heard his name tonight, but I know he's been out there.
Yeah. Two fouls. He's one of those grinder players. Navigado wide open. Oh. They're going to call a foul, and looks like that could call on a bunch of people. Looks like they're going to call that one on Nick Phillips. His second. The Duhawks have been struggling from the free throw line this game. I mean, they're only 5 of 8, but that's 62%, Matt, compared to Rockford's 4 of 5.
I mean, compared to what they've been shooting in the past free throw-wise, 90%. Going to have to pick it up at the foul line.
As the Duhawks get some subs in, Ali checks back in, as well as Kalinski, Drew Wallenschlager. And looks like Rowan McGowan's back in. Navigado misses the first of two attempts. And I know, at least in my high school days, the coaches hated missed free throws because they always said they're free, you shouldn't miss them, and we practice them enough in practice. And, I mean, he's got a point.
He does have a point. I mean, one thing that really, I'm sure, angered my coaches when I didn't make them, was it's an uncontested shot. I mean, you're pretty much standing there. Mm-hmm. Nobody in front of you, just follow through. Easy points that you can get. I mean, they say there's no such thing as a free lunch. I beg to differ with this.
Bass checked back in for Navigado. Rocker at the screen. Looks like they're going to call an illegal screen there on the freshman, Micah Swanson. really the first mistake that Swanson's made all day. He's really been playing well for this Rockford team. Ali running the point. Gets it to Rowan. Rowan up top to Tyler. Tyler at the top of the key. Driving in. Oh, he just gets bodied right there by Lacey. Sabet. Driving to the corner as Rowan can't handle that pass. Rowan gets a screen from Kolinsky. Comes off to Drew. Drew for three. No good. Rebound Swanson. That's kind of a deep three there by Drew. Don't know if he knew how much time was left on the shot clock or not, but. Oh, Tyler Bass with the steal. Using that long arms we were talking about. Gets off to Drew. Rowan driving in, and the rest is going to lined up out of bounds. Well, not lined up. I'm still in my football mode. Stepped out of bounds.
One thing that Rockford's got to capitalize on is they got to get the ball outside the arc. They're averaging, I mean, they got 18 of 63 three-pointers. That's not too good. 9 three-pointers per game, 27 points off of that. But, I mean, you're down 41-28. You want to get the most points out of your possession. Go for the threes.
Yeah. Oh, Bonds with a tough finish. But like you said, Matt, yeah, go for those threes. But you got to know sometimes when they're not falling, they're not going in to take your medicine and just, you know, get the twos, work it in.
Yeah.
Ali trying to use that quick speed to get around him. Dumps it off for three. Drew for three. No good. Rims off the back rim.
That's like the second or third shot he's put up that hasn't been able to go in.
Yeah.
He's one of those another three-point shooter that can help the Jayhawks out.
Ooh, nice step back there by Centers. That would have been a deadly shot if he would have made it. Ali with a little hezzy, dumping off to Drew. Drew, that one falls for him.
Jackson was playing offensive line there, blocking. Otherwise, that guy would have blocked Drew's shot without a doubt.
Good job by Drew. Just, you know, his past two threes didn't fall. Good job by him working it in the post, scoring those 2 points. Maybe just need something to fall.
For sure.
Lacey pull up from the elbow. Ooh, rims in and out. He won't be happy with that rim later.
The rim is not his friend.
Tyler with the cut. They're going to call a block. I believe they say he's in the restricted area.
43 points this first quarter, Hugh. I mean, we're 4 minutes and 21 seconds left in the quarter.
I mean, I love it. I love it.
I'm excited to see where they end up.
Looks like the ref's talking to the Rockford sideline as, oh, our man Luke Cunningham, the manager, hustling out there, wiping up that wet spot. Good job, Luke. Luke, one of the many basketball managers we have out here. Tyler Bass, his first free throw is up and drains it. Those are Tyler's first points of the game. Looking at last year's standings, I know it was a COVID year, but UD was ranked number 16 and they won it. As looks like Rockford's going to call a 30-second timeout, which gives us more time to talk about the standings last year, Matt. UD, the rival, ranked number 16 in the COVID year. They went 14-0, and I know they return a lot of those guys. So, you think Loras has a chance this year to upset them?
I mean, you're up 44 here. I mean, you've got 44 points here in the first quarter. We're not even done with it yet.
Mm-hmm.
I think Loras could give him a run for their money. As to winning, that's up in the air. I mean, ranked 16, Buena Vista is right there behind them. It'll be interesting to see how that goes when they meet up. I know I'll be there at that game, that's for sure.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, that and the Key City rivalry that we just had, those are the two big games between the crosstown rivals that just always go all out, both schools.
Yeah, and speaking of that Key City rivalry, the Jayhawks sadly fall up short, losing 17-14. And I know those football players aren't going to be happy. They're talking about how this is like one of the best years they've had in order to beat UD. And I know them losing that game has really just got to hurt them.
Yeah, I mean, me and you broadcasted that co-game, and they had such a close game against such a great running back, Alfonso Soko.
Yeah.
And, you know, not being able to close out the season with a win really, really hurts them.
Yeah. And, I mean, this is one of the best teams Loras has had in a while, you know.
Yeah.
Not really a football school, but Coach Helminiak's really building up that program. As Swanson can't handle the pass. Inside gets to Emmerich. Emmerich gets to the center. Centers for three on the wing. Drains it.
Okay.
And a little bit of rim as it goes in. Ali bringing it up. 3:50 left to go here in the first half. Ali pull up three. Short. Centers with the rebound. Rockford got one man to beat. Rowan, good defense. Oh. Swanson flying in, can't get it. Ali gets out to Rowan. Rowan, ooh, looks like he got fouled. Refs don't call it. Kalinske with the rebound. Pass. Fakes pass, driving it in. Getting to the big man, Kalinske, versus their big man, Swanson. Kalinske with the tough finish.
Great job with Kalinske, kicking it back out to Declan. Or excuse me, Bass, to get him back the ball, showing great discipline and teamwork there. I know he wanted to go up, but you got to utilize your teammates if you're down in the paint.
As the ref's going to call, a foul on a number one, Tyler Bass. Looks like it was an off-ball foul. As we get some subs in here for the Duhawks. Now Vigado checks back in. Alex Singleton comes back in the game. Miles Berry checks back in. And now Vigado, I mean, he's having a good game so far. Looking at how many rebounds he's got. He's got four rebounds, three offensive rebounds, and then one defensive rebound. I mean, he's really putting in the work down there.
I mean, they got 47 points. He's got three offensive rebounds. Yeah. Got to think how many of those points are coming off those three offensive rebounds, even in the first quarter.
Mm-hmm.
Those are great numbers offensively for him.
Yeah, and Kalinske's already got six boards, three on offense, three on defense. So, and then Declan has one offensive rebound right there. That is just, that's seven offensive rebounds there for the Duhawks already in the first half.
And that's just off of three players, too.
Yeah. As they're going to call a loose ball foul on Miles Berry.
Miles Berry, he's got two fouls already in the first quarter. He can't get into foul trouble this game. He's a great player. Might not be a good scorer, but he's a great assist player. He's a great player who can, you know, find the open guy, be a great defensive player. And when he gets into foul trouble, that's really hurting the Duhawks.
Yeah. He's really like that point guard, that leader out there for the Duhawks, wouldn't you say?
For sure.
Maybe he's more of a pass-first point guard. You don't really see that a whole bunch these days.
He's very rare.
Ali dumping off to Navigado. Cole can't go anywhere with the spin move. Has to dump it back out to Ali.
He's trying to set something up.
Oh, good defense there by Rockford, but they just can't mid it. As Navigado can't will it to go in. Alex Singleton, three men on him, and he gets fouled.
He's going to go to the line.
Cole Navigado really was trying to will that ball into the hoop there, sitting on the rim. Oh.
That just went around the rim and just fell right out. I was waiting for that one to go in.
Would have been a big boy finish.
Yeah.
I mean, that women game, I still can't get over how many threes they hit. That was insane.
Madison Haswell, she had 16 points just, I think, in the first half. That is unheard of.
So Alex, oof, misses that first free throw. I mean, 89-43. You don't see a lot of 45-point win games these days.
Yeah. I mean, that's something to be proud of, and that's something that's great to have in the beginning of the season too, because it sets forth a great momentum going into not just the season, but into conference play too. I mean, Wartburg seems to be the big obstacle in that ARC conference, and if Loras can put up games like this, they're going to be unstoppable.
Yeah, Wartburg ranked 10th, and actually Simpson, another rival in the conference, ranked 6th for women. So this ARC is definitely going to be a good conference this year for both men and women.
Yeah.
As Rockford's three is up, no good. They're going to call a foul on Charles Burnell with the shove, and Alex is in the air. Looking ahead at the men's schedule, their next game will be the 17th versus Greenville, 7:00. Ooh, Duhawks started off with five home games.
They go on the
four
road.
Four home games.
They go on the road for five games. And then they're back against Bethany Lutheran, Lawrence Luther, and Central.
And like that rivalry matchup we were talking about for the Duhawks, that's during J-term for us Duhawks students listening. They play number 16 University of Dubuque on January 12th.
I'll be here for that. I will make sure to be here.
Yeah, I'll make the drive back in.
Yeah.
We also, that's also our last home game of the year was against UD. So we're going to get him twice. As Rockford bringing it up now. Picked up by Ali. Ali really trying to force him to go right there as they throw it away. Miles running to it. And, oh, good defense by Emmerich, stripping that one away from Miles when he brought it down.
And just perhaps a miscommunication between Charles Burnell and his teammate. That just happens. You just got to make up for it.
Bonds for three? No good. Emmerich with the rebound. Nice pass to Swanson. Swanson misses the layup. Bonds with the rebound. Strips it away.
Swanson, he's just, it's not falling in for him,
yeah.
Man.
Started off so hot, too. Minute 35 left to go here in this first half, and it's been an action-packed one at that. Is they're going to call a foul on Swanson, holding Navigado. A little bit of pass interference, if you will, Matt.
I would agree with that. Throw the flag. Where's the flag?
Looks like Declan's going to check back in for this last minute 30 here.
And Loras already at 50 points. Both teams are already in the bonus.
As Navigado's first free throw is good, and Declan's going to check back in for the freshman, Alex Singleton.
Rowan McGowan's already got 12 points.
Cole Navigado at 9. If he hits this here, he'll be in double digits. Navigado's second free throw is up, going 2 for 2 from the line. Brunell bringing it up here. For Rockford, dumps off to Bonds. Good back cut by Bonds on Declan, and he scores it for two.
Charles Burnell and DJ Bond, along with Swanson, those are the three big guys for Rockford that just got to play their hearts out this game to keep up with the Duhawks.
Miles Berry's layup's no good. Navigado with another offensive rebound. Navigado gets out to Berry. Berry driving in, dumping off to Navigado, who gets fouled. He'll go back to the line. Man, Navigado's kind of just lived at the line this game. He'll be shooting his eighth attempt.
If he's already got 10 points, what are those points compared to the free throw line? I mean, he's got a lot right there.
Yeah. He's got 4 points from the line, shooting 4 of 6, 66%. His first attempt is up. It's good off the front of the rim, rolling in. I mean, this Duhawks. Right now, without another score, they're on pace for 106. And that's something. So Navigado's second one is up and good. Brunell pushing up the court here at the minute left to play in this first half. Gets it to Bonds. Bonds picked up by Ali Sabet. Ooh, nice move by Bonds. And he dumps it off. And he's telling his big man, number 32, Connor Harn, who just recently checked into the game. And Bonds kind of had an open layup there. I don't know why he didn't take that. He tried to dump it off, and he's a little upset that his teammate didn't cut.
I mean, you want to be selfless, and you want to use your teammates, but.
Oh, a nice three there by Emmerich, fading out of bounds.
Hey, if it works, it works.
Yeah.
If it's clicking, it's clicking.
3 points is 3 points. It goes on the board the same as there's a foul call. Looks like they're going to call that one on 32 Connor Harn. Ooh.
Navigado at the line again.
Connor Harns had a tough around 30 seconds that he's checked into this game.
Yeah.
Getting yelled at by his teammate Bonds, and now his foul. Navigado's free throw is up and has drained it. The live stats that I'm using here have Navigado at 11, but our scoreboard live has him at 13. Which one do you think's right, Matt?
13. Scoreboard. Although we had trouble with the scoreboard last
game. Yeah, the scoreboard was struggling a little bit last game.
I think it's been picking up, especially with that, especially with the points.
As Lacey, who took off his headband now, drives in and finishes. Oh, maybe the headband's been what's causing the problem.
LeBron James did it in the finals, won the finals. Maybe he's doing it here.
As Barry, Duhawks going to play for the final shot here, 15 ticking. Barry picked up by Emmerich. Duhawks going to get two high posts here. Oh, a little flare screen going nowhere. Thrown up to Navigado. And Duhawk ball. Barry kind of forced that pass there. Not necessarily. He could look for something else, but 3 seconds left. And it looks like We got a timeout here by, it looks like, the Duhawks and Coach Martin.
Going into the second quarter, what do you want to see from the Duhawks? I mean, they've had an outstanding first quarter, going up 13 points, over 50 points in the first quarter. I mean, I haven't seen anything like this.
Yeah, I know this offense production's great, but like I said earlier, you know, we were up pretty big last year against them, and then coming out of halftime, I don't think we had that same energy, and Rockford just doubled that energy, maybe even tripled it, and I think that'll be the biggest part for this Duhawk team and Coach Chris Martin, is to come out that same energy, and don't let Rockford, you know, come out and have that more energy, because that happens, that's how you lose games.
They talked about playing with fire and putting your foot on the gas and just going. Hopefully they don't run out of gas.
Yeah. As 3 seconds left here in this first half. Barry inbounding it, throwing it up, and Bonds picks it off. Bonds going to go up with it and lays it up and cutting that lead to 11 going into the half.
Maybe some momentum there for Rockford. Good steal and good layup. I don't know about you, but I was expecting a dunk.
I was expecting a dunk, too.
Yeah.
So looking at the first half, the leading scores for the Duhawks. If you're going off the scoreboard, it's Colton Avogado with 13. Then Rowan McGowan with 12. And he hasn't really done much after that first couple of minutes in that first half. He's really slowed off and maybe became more of a playmaker. And looking at the rebounds, I mean, Navigado's now got 4 offensive rebounds. And Kalinske still with 3. Kalinske didn't play much at the end of that half. Maybe resting him up for the second half, you think, Matt?
I would think so. I mean, you want to utilize Navigado. One guy who I personally want to see in, David Grinch. Yeah. This guy's checking in at 7 foot. I mean, that would be amazing to see him play. But nonetheless, Kalinske, you know, maybe he had a small injury or something, resting it for the second half. You know, given the history between these two teams, you want to save your best players for the end of the game.
And so if you're Rockford, what are you going to look to switch up at halftime?
I mean, you're only down by 11. I mean, you know, it is a high-scoring game.
Doesn't really feel like they're down by 11. Feels like they're down by more than that,
yeah,
honestly.
Yeah, it does feel down. I think mostly because they scored 55 points in the first half. But you just, you know, capitalize, stay out of foul trouble. That's a big thing. Stay out of foul trouble. Try not to get Navigado to the line so much.
Yeah.
You know, try to box out. I mean, you got, you know, 3 to 4 guys on this Duhawk team that already have 6 to 4 rebounds in the first half. Stop that. Box out.
Yeah. So that'll be it for the first half. A high-scoring one. At the end of the first half, your Loras College Duhawks 55, Rockford Regents 44. And we'll pick back up with you guys for the second half. It'll be an action-packed one. Stay tuned. Hello and welcome back to the Lillis Court here at the AWC at Loras College. And boy, that first half was really jam-packed, wouldn't you say, Matt?
I highly agree with you, Hugh. I mean, 55 points to 44. I'm expecting an electrifying second half, if you ask me. I'm expecting to come out firing, shooting threes, getting dunks, stuffing. I mean, I'm expecting it all.
I mean, we would love to see another dunk, especially of that magnitude that TJ Lacey had to start the game off. I mean, come on now.
We can start the second half off like that now. We're talking.
And like we said before the break, yeah, it's only an 11-point game, but it really feels like it's more of like a 20-point game.
Yeah.
It feels like Loras has really ran over this Rockford Regents team.
I highly agree with you. I mean, it'll be interesting to see what both teams do coming out in the second half. But one guy to keep your eye on for Rockford is Swanson. I mean, Micah Swanson's been a huge factor for them. And I just can't wait to see what he does.
And the starting five out here for the Duhawks is the same that started the game. Ali Sabet, Miles Berry, Cole Navigado, Jackson Kalinske, and I think that's everybody. Ron McGowan. There we go. As Rockford starts off the second half with a miss, and Navigado with another rebound. Look out for that double-double from Navigado. Berry pushing up, gets to Rowan. Navigado with it. Ali, as there's a dead ball foul on Lacey for Rockford with 19:36 left to play here in this second half.
I know how you wanted to come out and start the second half for Rockford, as Swanson's going to come out for the big man, Connor Harn. He was the guy who was getting near full last time,
yeah,
towards the end
was.
Of the first half.
Yeah, Swanson has four fouls, so he's on that break of fouling out.
One more and he's gone.
Yeah.
As much as I want to see Loras win, I would love to see him still stay in the game and play.
Yeah. Rockford telling them to push the ball as they get it to center for a step back three. He really likes going to that move and hasn't worked out for him all but once, and they're going to call over the back foul on Navigato. Looking at the usage from the first half, Rome McGowan, 37%. I mean, that's a pretty high amount of usage. And then looking at the plus-minus, Cole Navigato with plus 16 and Jackson Kalinske with plus 14. I mean, when they're out there, this Duhok team's really clicking on all cylinders.
And it's interesting to see both of them out there as they're both kind of their big man.
Mm-hmm.
So it'll be interesting to see what kind of defensive set they go into.
Connor Harn's day just keeps getting worse and worse. He's just called for a travel.
Man.
And travel, that's kind of a bug that the women's team last game. Sammy Martin, a couple travels, like almost back-to-back possessions, it seemed like.
You're correct. She struggled with it, back-to-back. Something she just couldn't get rid of, but she managed to get it under control and had herself quite the game.
As Ali airballs the floater, Barrett the rebound, gets it to Kalinske. Kalinske no good.
Ooh.
Lacey cannot bring it in.
He was going up, just couldn't bring it in. I mean, that's you just never see that, really.
Yeah. Maybe he thought somebody else might have been there, so he's bracing for that contact. But, never know.
Certainly.
Kalinske with it now. Looks like they're trying to run a play for McGowan, and it worked. He's wide open in the corner.
Behind the arc. Oh.
No good. They're going to call. Ooh.
They're call
a push on Jackson Kalinske. I don't know about that one.
I'd have to disagree.
Yeah. So far, we're a minute 30 into the second half and no scoring.
Surprisingly, how much they've been using Kalinske down in the paint, I am surprised he's only got one foul.
Yeah.
He's a big guy, likes to get dirty.
Harn for three. No good.
Bottom of the backboard right there.
Yeah, as Ali ran it up. Gets to McGowan. McGowan gets that little, creates that separation, and that was a beauty from Rowan McGowan.
And that's something I feel like only experience can teach you playing, here at Loras.
Creating that space, it's something all good scores have done throughout the history of basketball. I mean, one of the best space creators in all of basketball is probably Michael Jordan. Nobody creates space like him as centers. Misses another three, and Rockford is kind of. I bet that outside weather is really affecting them. They're about shooting as cold as it is outside right now.
18-63.
Oh, Ali wide open. He gets the layup.
It's a bet there, creating space, working his way around, getting 2 points for himself. Patting those stats. 59-44.
Emmerich for three. No good. And, that one was off Navigato as he tipped it out.
I thought that one might have been off of Connor Harn. Thank goodness it wasn't. Otherwise, I don't know.
Would have been a long bus ride back for him.
Yeah.
As Nick Phillips checks back in for the game. And it looks like DJ Bonds is also back into the game. They get it to Lacey. Lacey looking to do something with it. Takes it in. They're going to call. Ooh, a block. Must have been the restricted area. Lacey, we've seen it. He's not much of a shooter. He's more of the drive-in slasher type of guy. Lacey going up for two free throws here. First one rims out, no good.
This Rockford team has had trouble shooting, whether it's from the free throw line, the three-point line. They just can't get their shots in. It's just been unbelievably hurting them the second half and the first half, too. You just got to know, when does the bleeding stop for them?
As the Duhawks get it to sophomore transfer Ali Sabet. Now get it to the freshman Bass and the graduate student Rowan McGowan. Ali with it. Oh, give it to Kalinske. He's got the mismatch. He gets doubled in. Yeah, there's the foul. A little confused on why the ref on the baseline didn't call it, and it was right in front of him. The one on the sideline had to call that one. Yeah. That's a little confusing to me.
Someone's got to call it. Doesn't matter who it is.
Nonetheless, he will be shooting two free throws here.
I think it's the first time we've seen Kalinske at the line tonight.
It's actually the second time. He went 2-for-2 the first time, and now he's 2-for-3. Now Vigado's 7-for-10 from the line. And 10 attempts from the free throw line, that is something to gotta be happy with as Kalinske misses both. But McGowan gets the rebound. Ali wide open for three. Ali drains it. Ali Sabet lighting it up tonight. Emmerich bringing it up now. Driving in on Ali, goes nowhere, kicks it out. Bell driving in, gives it to Emmerich. Emmerich for a deep three. Drains it, answers a three with his own.
There we go.
Clark was calling for that one. Oh, Ali getting guard tight by Emmerich. Ali looking to make something happen this possession. Dumps it off to his freshman, Tyler. Ali guard tightly by Emmerich. Creates the space with the pick and roll. Ali shorts. Tyler Bass with a good rebound. McGowan driving in, and they're going to call a travel. A lot of body there. I believe that's the first turnover for the Duhawks in the second half.
I mean, great job by them. 16 minutes left in the second half. That's your first turnover.
Oh,
pretty good.
Good back cut by Bonds, and he gets blocked by Kalinske. Ali, they're going to call a foul on Emmerich. Oh, as the ref tumbles down. Ref took a bit of a tumble there.
Looks like he's okay along with Emmerich, too.
Emmerich making sure the ref's okay. Maybe trying to get on his good side after taking him down there. Just a 14-point game here.
Emmerich leads the team in minutes at 22. The next guy up is DJ Bonds. But
22 minutes, I mean, hey, it's a lot of work right there, especially for one. None of the Duhawk guys are at 20 yet. The highest one for us is Ali and McGowan. Oh. Barry picked up by Emmerich. Miles trying to create some space here. Declan picked up by Bonds. Gets to Navigado. Barry on the... Oh, he had Navigado wide open. But, hey, three's better anyways. But we miss it. And... Oh, foul on the three by Nick Phillips. He was the beneficiary of that call in the first half. And... He's not happy about it.
He's going to have three shots coming his way, Clark.
Griffin Clark, the senior from Fairfax, Iowa, went to school at Cedar Rapids Prairie and spent a couple years at Kirkwood Community College before coming over and being a Duhawk. Kirkwood Eagles, Loras College Duhawks, all in that bird family.
Yeah. He must like to fly.
I mean, he lets it fly from three, so.
Yeah.
Clark's first free throw attempt was good. His second one is up and off the back of the rim.
Charles Burnwell coming in for Rockford. He's replacing
Phillips, who just committed that foul in. I noticed something with Phillips last year. I mean, his temper, you know, I think he struggles keeping that one intact as Clark's just rims out. And I know he struggled with it, keeping the temper, you know, in check. And I know a lot of people tend to have that, so it's a good job by the coaches, you know, maybe keeping under check as Declan knocks that one out.
I mean, you talk about keeping your temper and stuff. I mean, Loras was up so big, and Rockford came back and almost had the win.
Mm-hmm.
And you can't blame him really for having, I guess, you know, keeping under control, but playing with some passion.
Yeah. Lacey driving in. Euro, no good.
Ooh.
Clark with the rebound. It's going to be a foul. A number 12, Charles Burnell for Rockford.
Clark's heading back to... Actually, it's going to be an inbounds play here.
Our color commentator, EJ Greenberg, is doing the PA announcing down there. Look at EJ. He's all grown up now. Barry driving and kicking to Clark. Wide open in the corner. No good. Tipped around, and Emmerich comes down with it, pushing the pace. Oh, no, trying to get a little too fancy.
Navigato at the right place at the right time.
Yeah, very double-teamed.
He's picked up his dribble. He's got a pass.
Go. Singleton. Oh, Declan in the corner for three.
Bang!
Declan.
There we go.
Making him pay for that double-team. Good movement there by the Duhawks on offense. Barry breaking that that double-team. Then Alex just moving into the corner. Rockford, they are just not on the same page right now. Maybe a little flustered as their head coach is going to ask for a full timeout. And just as we talked about it being an 11-point game, it's now a 18-point game, man. I guess the Duhawks, they came out with that energy that they maybe lacked last year against this Rockford team in the second half.
Indeed. I mean, there's, you know, 14 minutes left in the game, but this game could possibly be slipping through Rockford's hands. They did keep it close going into halftime. At 11, you know, at 11 differential, now it's at 18. You got to hope that, you know, they can stop something going on, you know, whether it's internal or external. It's going to be a long bus ride back if they let this game get away from them.
If you're Rockford's head coach, Jeremy Regal, when would you put Swanson back in the game with his four fouls and being on that foul trouble? I think it'd have to be soon with you. This game almost getting out of hand. You got to do something quick.
I would agree soon, but, you know, do you put him in? I mean, actually, he looks like he's coming in now.
Yeah, I saw him check back in. That's what made me think of the question.
Okay. I mean, you know, do you use him now with the chance of him fouling out and you can't use him later on in the game, or do you wait where the game then potentially gets out of your hands and there's really no point in using him?
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's, you know, you might get burned both ways.
And the Rockford scores, the only person in double digits is DJ Bonds. Swanson, you know, he started off hot. You know, he's got eight points, only two rebounds. It's kind of shocking he's only got two with this big frame. As Barry bringing it up now. Gets it to Clark. The star-studded freshman, Alex Singleton, with it now. Declan on the wing. Miles Barry, the sophomore, uses that pick and roll. Gets it to Clark, wide open. Good recovery there by Brunell. Oh, they're going to target Swanson with that four fouls. No good. Alex knocked down to the ground.
And, Hugh, I would watch out for Loras trying to get Swanson fouled out of the game.
Oh, Rockford for three. No good. They have gone ice cold at the start of this second half from downtown. And, honestly, they've gone ice cold from everywhere. They start out with 44 points, and they've only scored four so far, Matt.
Not good compared to Loras' 11.
Oh, they're going to call a charge.
Oh!
A big charge, little anticlimactic, if you ask me. The rest are kind of staring at each other, wondering who's going to make that call there.
I mean, he made the three, too.
Yeah. I mean, they take one step forward, two steps back.
Not a good look.
Looks like Rockford going to start picking the Duhawks up at half court. Nope. Emmerich backs off. He's got his head on a swivel looking for that screen. Miles Barry wide open. Good screen by Navigato on the backside. Getting, you know, Barry wide open.
Navigato not down in the paint behind the arc. You know, he's such a versatile player. You can use him in the paint. Use him behind the arc.
Oh, did he just foul out? Oh. We're going to call that one on Cole Navigato.
Okay.
As we get a new rotation and coming in for the Duhawks. Rome McGowan checking back in. As well as Drew Wallenschlager, Alisa Bett, Jackson Kalinske, and Tyler Bass. Like you said earlier, you know, having Kalinske and Navigato out there at the same time, and looks like head coach Chris Martin's switched that up as Ali goes flying on Emmerich's three attempt, and Emmerich hits it
for
Rockford.
And I understand, you know, you want to have, you know, you don't want to have him out at the same time, but Tyler Bass, Jackson Kalinske, Rowan McGowan, those guys are coming in at, you know, 6'6", 6'4".
Yeah.
There really is no need for Navigato. Get him some rest and have him play towards the end of the game when you might need him.
Ooh, Ali lost that floater. I mean, you know, in my book, I'll give him an assist for that one.
Yeah.
As Tyler gets the rebound or lob pass. Puts it in for two. Swanson's got Kalinske on him. Swanson, little shimmy shake, baby hook. No good. Kalinske with the rebound.
Kalinske, he's got himself, you know, having himself a game. He's got 7 rebounds. That's leading the Duhawk team. I mean, actually, excuse me, that's tied with Paul Navigato.
Tyler Bass says, let me join in on the action from three. And his first three of the game. And that was a nice play by Ali Sabet to get him open. We got him picking up Bonds. Drew now guarding Brunell. Brunell passing it out to Bell as Bell drives in, gets it over Kolinsky. Ali pushing it up the court now. Well, not pushing up, a light little jog. Kolinsky gets it to him. Kolinsky is wide open on the roll, and foul? Drew with the rebound, and the refs don't know, and they're going to say Loras ball.
You know, you talked about pushing it up the ball or pushing it up or jogging it up. You're up by 20, 11, 12 minutes left. And, you know, you really don't want to start pushing it down Rockford's throat just yet. Mm-hmm. I think you want to take some time off the clock, and then maybe push.
Rowan for three. No good. Emmerich with the rebound. Emmerich, nice little pass to Bonds. Bonds, I mean, at the rim by McGowan, and he finishes it.
Great job by Bonds getting the ball, finding, you know, looking at where he's at. He wasn't too sure where he was and found his opportunity and capitalized. Now he finds himself at the line, potential three-point play here.
Bonds' free throw attempt is up, and he converts the and one. Bonds now at 15, the leading scorer for the Rockford Regents. Drew gets it to Kolinsky. Kolinsky hand that one off to Ali Sabet. Ali gets past Swanson. No good, but Kolinsky flying in, tapping it in.
Man, oh man, is he a factor.
As Brunell driving in. Wisely backs out to the corner. Got the freshman on senior right there. As Emmerich's three is short off the front of the rim. Brunell with that hustle play getting the rebound. Bonds driving it in, and they're going to call. Yep. I think Kolinsky tried to take a charge there, but, I mean, when you're 6'6", 220, and the guy's trying to take a charge from a 6'1", 165, I don't know how often you're going to get that charge call.
I don't know either. I mean, picking on the big man and pick on someone your own size, maybe.
Bonds free throws up, and it's good. Now an 18-point game here.
Navigato and Kolinsky both in the game. We'll see what they do here with those two guys, Ryan Bass and Rowan McGowan. It looks like, you know, the only guy looks like under 6 foot is Sabet out there.
Yeah. Nali's a pretty tall guy, too.
I mean,
he's lanky. He's a deceptive around 6 foot. Only if we had him on our sheet, we would know how tall he is.
I think one thing Coach Martin's trying to do is he realizes how many second opportunities Rockford's getting off these missed shots.
Mm-hmm.
He's putting all his tall guys out there, getting the rebounds, and just, you know, getting the ball to Sabet, then getting the ball back inside those tall guys and really driving up that score.
Oh! Kolinsky, just not enough bunnies on that one.
Hanging on the rim, watching the ball come out.
Ali gets the rebound. He wants to get in on that action. Ali using that quick speed, getting out to Bass for the corner. Ali for three. Bass! What a play.
Okay.
He kept his foot down.
I thought that was an up and down.
So did I.
I was waiting for the whistle.
I think everybody in the stadium thought it was that. Bell doesn't really know what to do with it with the Kolinsky on him. Good switch there. Rockford really working it inside now. Emmerich, a deep three. No good.
Ooh.
And
look at him call a foul.
Yeah, on Tyler Bass. Interesting call there.
If anything, I thought it might have been on Navigato.
I believe Bonds will be having two attempts from the line here. Both teams are in the bonus, so from here on out, we'll be shooting free throws.
No more inbound plays. This is where those free points come into play. It can either benefit you or hurt you. So it really, you know, it depends on how well you capitalize on these opportunities that you're being given.
Yeah, most definitely. Ali Sabet has now hit. Ali Sabet and Rowan McGowan have now hit 21 minutes in the game for the Duhawks. Good job by. I guess that kind of shows the depth of this Duhawk team that just now, with 9 minutes left to go in the game, that the Duhawks' first players hit 20 minutes.
I mean, you got so many players. Mm-hmm. Ali Sabet being one of those, you know, rather versatile, shifty guys, mm-hmm. along with Declan, along with Miles, and so on and so forth. You know, one thing I've noticed is Loras really has the small guys and then the big guys.
Yeah.
There really is no middle guy.
And it looks like the ref's going to call a hook on Navigado. A lot of times refs don't call that.
I don't think I've ever heard of that foul.
Yeah. Say when it happens, it really hinders the defender. Not allowed to make that move on the ball with the hook, as Bernal's floater, no good. Duhawks, same team, they knock it out of bounds.
Navigado in the middle of that scuffle there. He's coming out. If I was Coach Martin, I would just sit him, get him some rest, put him in maybe 3 minutes, mm-hmm. and then just let him run it from there.
And a stat that's really stuck out for me right now, Ali Sabet, for how much he's handling the ball, 5 assists, only 1 turnover. I mean, that's great. That's just great ball handling right there by Ali. I think the Duhawks found their point guard for the next couple of years to come.
I highly agree. I think, you know, Sabet's doing a great job, but those defenders are bringing it in too.
Mm-hmm.
So many broken up passes we've seen. You know, even in the women's game too, there were a lot of broken up passes.
Yeah.
And being able to connect with your teammates is huge.
Colton Navigado also coming out of the game because that was his fourth foul. So, I mean, Coach Martin keeping him safe for the time being with this game now at 19 points. And like you said about Miles Berry earlier in the game, he's one of those more of the defending type players. You know, he makes a couple passes, but what's really stood out to me is his 3 steals in today's game. I mean, you don't really see a whole lot of steals by players. I mean, defense really took the back burner, especially in the newer days. Ali creating some space. Clark for 3.
Oh, just off the rim.
Emmerich with the rebound. Uh-oh. Ali on Lacey. That's not a matchup that the Duhawks want to see.
He just dominates the bet. I mean, you know, aggressiveness versus skill versus, you know, shiftiness.
Yeah,
aggressiveness
size
is going to win the majority of the time.
Yeah, he's got, I mean, Lacey's listed at 6'2", 200. I mean, Ali can't be more than a $175, I'd say.
Give him $180.
Well, why don't we just pull up the men's roster and see what he's listed at here. Ali Sabez listed at 6'2", 180. So
okay.
A 6'2 point guard, I mean, that really helps out, you know. It's a good size for these point guards. They're able to see the floor better and all that stuff. So, Matt, taking a look at the Duhawks' next couple games, looking at their first conference game is not until the 23rd, so 10 days from now, and they play Simpson. I think the Duhawks will perform that day.
Well, given the performance they've given here, I think that'll be great. Now, also, I don't know too much about Simpson,
mm-hmm.
type of defense and offense they run and so forth and so on and so forth. You know, but I think Loras can keep up with them. I think they play a game like they have today. They try to keep their big men out of foul trouble. I think they're going to give Simpson a run for their money.
Yeah. As Ali driving in, dumps off to Tyler.
There we go.
Ali just keeps on making plays out there.
Good job by Tyler, just, you know, breaking in, cutting in to the baseline.
Oh, and he stepped over the line before he inbounded it. That's just a mental lapse right there by, I believe that's Centers.
Zach Centers, yeah.
Looking at our December schedule, we're playing 2 California teams on the 17th and 19th. California Lutheran and L.A. Verney? Is that how you say it?
Are we going out to California or are they coming here?
It looks like they're coming here.
Okay. You know, that great experience, though, for Loras, reaching out to the West Coast and Not saying, you know, within the tri-state area. Not, you know,
getting
Illinois,
that
Wisconsin.
Competition, you know?
Yeah, it's a different kind of basketball. You could say the West Coast style,
yeah,
if you will.
West Coast style, that's a lot more high pace.
Yeah.
Little, almost like a 7 seconds or less offense.
Yeah.
Lacey, guarded by Alex. Ooh, that looked like all ball, but the referee did not agree with me, as that tends to happen pretty often. 20-point game here with 8 minutes left to go.
I mean, what do you want to see out of Loras? You know, going in after this game, seems a pretty, you know, they got this one in the bag, but heading to Simpson, heading to California schools, what do you hope to see out of them?
You know, I'm really hoping to see them, you know, it's early in the season. You just want to see them improve day by day. And then I guess with that, obviously, with improvements come expectations. You want to see them meet those expectations. You know, honestly, it'll be hard for them to beat UD in conference ranked 16th. But we did finish third last year. Granted, it was COVID year. We only played, I believe it was 13 games, 13 or 12 games. So I guess I'd really look for them to finish second, or maybe even give UD a run for their money and finish first in conference. It's all about making those improvements. I think they have a good chance at getting second this year.
And I think, too, they've got great additions with Ryan Bass, Ali Sabat. You know, as
Emmerich drills a three from the corner.
Yeah.
Duhawk's pushing it up the court now.
I think, like we just said earlier, jogging or pushing. I think now's the time to push.
Yeah. Take their will out of the game after hitting that three. Might have a little more momentum with them.
Yeah.
As Alex dumps it off to Declan. Declan,
there we go,
with
baby.
The finish.
Declan's been really quiet tonight, but hopefully he can continually come up big.
Phillips for three. Ooh, rims in and out. I mean, that was a great pass by Alex, too, finding Declan.
For sure. And Declan being able to capitalize, like, you know, hasn't been able a big factor tonight, but.
That is Miles Berry's fourth turnover of the game right there.
I thought you were going to say fourth foul for a second. No. I was like, no.
No, he's only got two. The only foul trouble the Duhawks are in is Navigato with four. And then McGowan has three. Looks like Bass has three, and Drew has three. As Lacey's bringing it up the court. Man, he is fast. Emmerich, deep three.
Oh,
my
okay.
Gosh, this man is lighting up this second half.
You know, I think we talked about Swanson being the guy to put the team on their back. Yeah. He's in foul trouble now. Emmerich, he's taking over the
game. He did come into the game as their leading scorer, averaging 16 a game.
Okay.
And he's got 18 right now as Declan answers with a three of his own.
Declan's starting to turn into that X factor for Loras.
Lacey, I mean, he's just a really quick player. As Declan forced him to go left, and ooh. Left hand must not be his strong suit. They're doing all that scouting. Ali pushed up to Declan. Declan, nice pass to Kalinske.
Oh!
As they're going to call a foul on Kalinske with a hook.
Second time they've called that tonight. One on Navigato and one on Kalinske.
Coach Martin is not happy with that call, and I don't blame him. Bell bringing it up now here for the Regents. Oh, the disrespect. He says, you better step up on me next time, Kalinske. Ali bringing it up. As this Rockford bench starting to get into it, they've cut it down to a 14-point game.
The one thing you just hope doesn't happen is Loras gets comfortable with the lead. And defensively, they just don't play as aggressive.
Mm-hmm.
They want to play hard defense. Don't play soft.
Oh, nice pass by Bell to center.
Okay.
Coach Chris Martin, I mean, if the Duhawks don't score here, I mean, I think he might need to call a timeout.
I think,
he's going to call it right now.
Yeah. Navigato might be coming into the game, maybe replacing Kalinske or one of those other tall guys. A reminder, he is in foul trouble, so he's got to be very diligent and very careful how he moves throughout the court.
And Kalinske is talking to the ref here. As one of the assistant coaches getting him away from the ref. And I don't blame Kalinske for getting a little upset over that call. I mean, it's a pretty tic-tac foul if you ask me.
I mean, like you get like the history given of between the two teams, a foul like that, you're up by 12.
Yeah.
But that could be a momentum change for the game. Something that would just hinder Loras's you know, efforts to keep going, keep pushing, and really, you know, just the mental state of Kalinske.
Yeah.
He's been such a strong guy the entire game.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, granted, he's only got, you know, one. No, actually, he is. He does have three fouls. So, you know, he doesn't want to be sitting out with four.
Yeah.
This deep into the game.
Yeah, 100%. And looking at us talking about Rowan McGowan and his impact in this program, he is, in fact, the program leader in three-pointers over his career. So it just shows the leadership that they're bringing back with the grad student. As Navigado does indeed check back in, and Swanson's also back in there. So look out for number 23 in white, Cole Navigado with four fouls, and number two in purple, Micah Swanson, who also has four fouls.
We'll have to see who fouls out first.
Yeah.
One of the two, and Jackson Kalinske's in there too.
And Kalinske, you know, talking to that ref, you just got to make sure his mindset's right, you know, not playing frustrated, because when you play like that, the refs are going to target you more and
get on
you're
their
only
bad
hurt
side,
your
yeah.
team.
I understand you want to prove your point, and that's perfectly fine.
Mm-hmm.
But when, you know, you get on the ref's bad side, he might call even the smallest thing.
Oh! That's a foul. Emmerich goes flying out and takes out Rowan McGowan. And like we mentioned earlier, we enter the bonus with like 13 minutes left in the game, so it's going to be free throws. Rowan today from the free throw line, this is actually his first attempt.
He is 33% from the three-point line. He is the leading scorer in three-pointers. Shouldn't be too hard of a couple of shots he gets. You know, get his team to 90 points, that'll be big.
Mm-hmm. Rowan's up, drills it. Buyers are just flying all over the place. Luke's ready to take action, but looks like they don't need him to wipe up the sweat that time. McGowan's second one's up. Ooh, that is a nice stroke from the free throw line, Matt.
Free throw should be nothing when you lead the program in three-pointers.
Brunell picked up by Declan. McGowan guarding centers. Kalinske with Swanson. Ooh, nice spin move by Brunell. Air balls the fadeaway. Ali looking to run it up.
Sabet's going to try to maybe wear them out, run out the clock a bit.
Yeah, good job there by Ali. Just, you know, realized he didn't have the numbers and just brought the ball back out. Declan kicking it to Rowan. You can't leave him in the corner. Oh.
Declan comes up with the
Declan
rebound.
With the rebound, though. Rowan kicking it out. Ali's going to set it back up with 13 on the shot clock.
Chew that shot clock. Chew that shot clock as much as you can, but don't turn the ball over.
And that will be a foul on Brunell. Ali will go to the line to shoot, too. Ali, this will also be his first free throw attempt of the game. And that is Brunell's fourth personal foul. He has Brunell's stats so far in the game. No points, four fouls, four turnovers, and three assists with three rebounds.
Like we've been calling his name a lot, but you know those stats don't quite show it. Maybe for the fouls, but I mean,
yeah,
he's such a shifty guy, along with Bonds and a couple others for that Rockford team. And you know, really hoped he would have gone off this game. I mean, at least not on our Duhawks, but
most definitely. As Ali hits them both, giving them 13 points for the game, and Navigado hasn't scored in the second half. And the double-double has been confirmed for Jackson Kalinske. 10 rebounds and 10 points. As TJ Lacey checks back in for the Regents. And Swanson comes out. Looking a little tired out there when he's going to sit down. As Ali's going to walk this one up. Alex with it. Rowan gets a screen from Navigado. Navigado, had him on the roll. As Emmerich gets it off the steal. Oh, good defense by Ali to slow down the fast break. As Brunel doesn't want to take that one. Gets it up to Bell. Bell, no good.
Singleton comes into the game. We haven't seen him a lot in the second half.
Maybe that being him a freshman. We got, I mean, two freshmen out there. And only their second college game.
Yeah, him and Sabet.
Ali.
Oh, come on.
Tyler gets it. And one! Big finish there by Tyler Bass, the freshman. And, you know, we've talked about Ali being the transfer, the sophomore transfer. He transferred from Oakton Community College. And he had 21 points last game.
I mean, Bass has 3 rebounds, 5 of 6 for field goals, 83% shooting, 1 of 1 of 3 points, 17 minutes.
And the Duhawks have, they have 6 guys in double figures. Just showing that we're not a one-player-oriented team out here. Tyler hits both the free throws, or just the one free throw, because he got the and one. Brunel, been running the point this whole game. Gets to Emmerich in the corner. Emmerich is 3. No good. Scrum for it, and that's, he's going to say Rockford ball.
Emmerich, he's had a couple good three-pointers tonight from behind the arc. You know, he keeps taking shots, hoping something would fall. Shoot. And I wouldn't blame him, you know. 95 to 76, you need anything. And, you know, if you can get the most points out of a play, take it.
Brunel picked up by Alex. Alex Singleton on him. Goes nowhere. Ooh, now we got a little late on that steal. Emmerich pull up midi.
I just love the speed and the shiftiness from Emmerich on that play. The quickness, it was great. It was beautiful to watch.
Caught Navigato out of place there, going for that steal. Ali Sabet. Ooh, a tough finish from Ali. First time we've really seen him going to inside the paint. He's been living outside the arc all day.
Those are the kind of plays you're going to want to see him make going forward.
Navigato picking up Emmerich. Emmerich, such a shifty guy. Ooh, that was a beautiful pass. Bonds gets it to Bell. Bell with the finish over Bass, and Rockford's going to call a timeout with 2:38 left to go in their game. 97-80, 17-point game, and Rockford's kind of played it even here. They've only given up, what were they, down 11 at half?
Yeah.
They've really only been outscored by 6 points here in the second half.
You just hope it's not a repeat of what happened last game. I mean,
yeah, I mean, the Duhawks really have to implode here. 2:38 up by 17.
Yeah.
You just got to, yeah, but like you said, you just got to hope it doesn't happen.
It doesn't. I mean, they've been on somewhat of a little bit of a run, Rockford. I highly doubt anything will happen, but you just hope it doesn't.
Yeah. I mean, always. And this, I know Coach Martin, he's been here for a while. His career record at Loras is 85-36, and I mean, he knows how to win. And I bet he's preaching in that huddle right now. Take care of the ball. Get the best possible shot, and we're in no hurry.
And I think one thing, too, that we touched on is chew the clock. Chew the shot clock.
Yeah.
Don't try to force a shot. You don't want to go up too much and then give Rockford a chance to score. When you got the ball, take as much time as you can without turning the ball over, which is something you don't want to run into.
Yeah. As Ali bring it up, Ali's got seven assists and 15 points. Right behind McGowan, who's got 16 to lead the Duhawks in scoring. Tyler Bass, ooh, yeah, there's the call on Brunel. Oh, I believe that's Brunel's 5th foul of the game. I believe he's done.
Is he gone?
Unless my math has been wrong. Yep, that is his 5th. Scores tables. Give him the 5, tell him to come out, and looks like Zach Centers will come in for him, as Miles Berry's also going to check in for the Duhawks. McGowan coming out of the game here for the Duhawks. He's had an amazing game so far. 28 minutes, 1 rebound, 2 assists, 2 steals, and 16 points. I mean, talk about a stat sheet stuffer. Bass's first attempt is up and good. Bass has 14 points. Kind of been a quiet 14 a little bit.
I know.
And he's now at 15. Second on the team. He's at 16, actually. So he's just tied the lead score for the Duhawks' freshman, Tyler Bass. as Lacey gets the rebound. Emrich gets Barry going by him. Lacey, first three of the game. Oh, and he hits it. Oh, maybe he should have been shooting those earlier.
Rockford's been taking a lot of timeouts, and hopefully they haven't been hearing what we're saying because, I mean, Loras would have chewed the clock there. He wants to give his team as much time as he can to score, but you just hope that he doesn't need those timeouts later in the game.
Can't take him home with you. I mean, they only got one timeout left here, so, and the Duhawks have three, and both teams are at 10-plus team fouls, so I believe that is call for the double bonus.
I think so.
Looking at the leading score in the game, that's going to come from Rockford. That's going to be, Rockford will be. Looks like it's Brandon Emmerich. And they actually have the top two leading scores in this game. Brandon Emmerich with 22. And then DJ Bonds with 18. I mean, Rockford only has three guys in double digits compared to Loras's. Compared to Loras's six.
And Loras is six. I mean, their highest score is 16. They got two guys with 22 and 18.
Yeah.
So, you know, how would you want to weigh that out?
And, I mean, Alex Singleton is almost at double digits, too. He's at eight. And they also have a person who's at 9 points, and that is Jaden Bell. As Ali, he's got Bonds on him, trying to lose him. Oh, good job by Tyler to get it up, and Declan with it now. Declan, nice pass, nice cut. Good finish there by Miles. That's good teamwork right there. The two sophomores connected on that bounce pass, and the Duhawks are now at 101.
And the good thing about that is, like you said, they're sophomores. That connection will carry over this season and 2 years to come.
Yeah. As Lacey puts it up, the floater is good. And, Matt, what was the score at halftime? 55, right? 55-44?
Yes, sir.
And, I mean, I said we were on pace for, 106 at one point? Yeah, but we would be on pace for 110 now. I don't know if we're going to get 9 this last minute 30.
I don't know.
It would make my ego feel pretty good, though, if I called that one right.
It's looking like it. I mean, Sabet is trying to chew up some time here.
Declan with it. Good to Miles. Oh, Alex got a mismatch here. Alex, they're going to call a foul. And looks like that one is now on number 0, Jaden Bell. As Zach Centers comes back into the game, looks like Griffin Clark is also checking back into the game for the Duhawks. Griffin Clark was actually a starter last year, and he's coming off the bench now. And, I mean, coming off the bench, starting as a junior, and then coming off the bench as a senior, that's got to play with the head a little bit.
Yeah, but, I mean, you got guys like Sabet, Singleton, Bass. Those guys are freshmen.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, you had your spot last year, but I think Coach Martin's trying to give these guys – these freshmen an opportunity to play, see how they do, and if it doesn't work out, he's got a guy like Clark we can bring in.
Yeah. Alex missed his first attempt. He's shooting 57% from the line right now. He's 4 of 8, so he's shooting 50% now, and that's something Coach going to want to have to work on with him at practice, especially with his big frame. He'll be on the line a lot this year and for years to come. Emmerich with the Euro gets it to centers. Nowhere to go with it as they got Phillips wide open in the corner. They don't see him. Bonds for three? No, he'll drive in. He's going to try and draw a foul, and he does draw it, and they're going to call it on Tyler Bass.
Singleton just kind of like landed right behind him, you know, throwing his hands up, wondering what's going on. Bass now has four fouls.
And Sabet has now hit 30 minutes in the game, shooting 50% from the field, 5 of 10, then 50% from three. 3 of 6, and, I mean, that's efficient right there. As he checks out of the game, his day is probably done.
I mean, a guy like his size, four rebounds, I mean, it's not a Kalinske or a Navigado number, but...
But for a 6'2 point guard, that's something.
That's stellar, if you ask me.
That's a great... I mean, he's got a great stat line for a point guard. 15 points, 7 assists, 4 rebounds. I mean...
You can't ask for
much
more.
No, you can't. That's a beautiful stat line. His day is probably done as he checked out. And I'm going to assume this will be who we'll see end the game for the Duhawks with there only being 33 seconds left in the game.
Yeah. I mean, Rockford's only got a timeout left. Yeah. I highly doubt they'll want to use it right now.
Yeah, it'll just prolong the inevitable. As Miles Barry fakes the three, drives in, This is a Griffin Clark for three.
There we
and
go.
He hits it, getting the Duhawks to 104.
Maybe 106 will happen.
Hey,
we'll
maybe.
See.
I don't know. Oh, okay. Bonds from deep. That one's short. Miles Berry tips it to himself as they're going to call foul on, looks like,
Griffin?
TJ Lacey. Oh, the rest pointing at two people. Is
Lacey the one that seems to be injured on that play? He gets up and
a little shaken up. And looks like they're going to call a foul on Griffin Clark.
He collided with Lacey down there in the paint.
Yeah, they were just both going
five.
For the ball and kind of hit him as Luke just getting his money's worth today, wiping up all that sweat on the court.
Usually it's a pretty quiet day, but with two aggressive teams like these two, he's kind of busy. He's been busy.
And it's looking like this Rockford Regents team is going to fall to 2-1, and the Duhawks will move to 2-0. As Lacey's first attempt is up and no good, and he is a little frustrated as Micah Swanson checks back in for this last 12 seconds.
I think it's a great win for Coach Martin and the Duhawks as they head into conference play in a week. But, you know, this is a different type of team than what they'll see in the ARC.
Yeah. As Miles Berry just gets to the cross, and it'll be the inevitable as this clock runs out. And after 40 minutes of basketball, your Loras College Duhawks 104 and the Rockford Regents 87. And Matt, like we said, we love seeing us some offense.
Yeah, we do.
And these two teams did not disappoint us.
Indeed they didn't. 104-87, like you said. Too short of your prediction.
I know, It's so close.
Yeah.
They knew I predicted this. So
they did.
We can't give it to them. But, yeah, the next game for the Duhawks will be on November 17th versus Greenville at 7 p.m. And we won't be doing that one, but you're definitely going to want to check it out on the Duhawks.com athletics. And signing off for Matt Haddad, I'm Hugh Molony, and thanks for listening. We'll catch you guys next time.